Hi students, now in previous class we have been discussed about the flowering animals. How do we select the site? Which site is suitable for the animals? How do you sowing the seeds? Pricking of seedlings, transplanting, watering and feeding, stacking, pinching and disbudding. And then classification of animals. So there are different kinds of animals are there. Early blooming animals, late blooming animals, white flowered animals, blue, purple and lavender flowered animals, yellow and orange flowered animals, animals for hanging basket, animals for rockery, fragrant animals, animals suitable for shade. So first one is early blooming animals. Azuretum, Alysum, Maritenum, Amaranthus, Brovalia, Silosia, Coreopsis, Drummondi, Cosmos, Gomphorina, Impatiens, Balsamia, Salvia, Tacitus and Ginnia are used as early blooming animals, and late blooming animals Abronia umbellata, Althea rosea, Ancusa capensis. So Ancusa papensis, the common name of this is blue bird. And then Antirrhinum, Arctostis grandis, Centuria sinus, Keranthus keri, Chrysanthemum carnatum. Actually it is called as annual tricolor chrysanthemum. Dianthus species like carnation, pink, sweet william, etc. Next Gilia capitata, Gilia tricolor, Matthiola, Salvia viscaria, Salvia harmonium, Salvia coccinea as used as late blooming annuals. And white flowered annuals, Alysum, Callistippus canensis, Convolvulus major, Callistippus canensis is the common name of this one is China aster. And Convolvulus major, Dianthus, also called as a double white Margaret, double white Margaret, Matthiola, various whites, Nigella, phlox, various whites, papaver and Zinnia are used as white flowered annuals. Blue, purple and lavender flowered annuals, Azaretum mexicanum, Ancusa, Brovelia, Elasta, Elata, Calistippus chinensis, Centuria sinus, Tritoria chinensis, Tritoria termacea, Convolvulus minor, Delphinium mazasis, Delphinium hybridum, Echium plantaginum, Gilla capitata, Heliotropium arborensis, Iperi umbellate, Ipomia abrocalia, Carulia, Lobelia erinus, Myosotis, Petunia hybrida, also called as blue lace. Petunia hybrida, the common name is blue lace or black magic. And Salvia farinacea, Viola tricolor hortensis and Verbena and the hybrid are used as blue, purple and lavender flowered annuals. Next, yellow and orange flowered annuals. For example, Cacalia lucia, Calendula officinalis, Dimorphotheca orangea, Isogelia californica, Tacitus, Trophiolum and Zinnia are the example of yellow and orange flowered annuals. Annuals for hanging basket, Azaretum or dwarf, Hymenotherium tenuitolium, Lobelia or basket type, Petunia, Phlox, Portulaca, Trophiolum canaringa, Torianaya, Verbena and Zinnia linearis are the example of annuals for hanging basket. And then annuals for rockery. So is it confuses ma? So lot of annual plants are there. So just I want to give names to you. Don't be learn it is. Just you have to idea what are the type of annual plants are there, especially in flowering plants. So next, annuals for rockery. So especially they are grow in different regions, especially in humid regions and dry regions. First one is humid regions, Azaretum, Alysum brachycomb, Phlox, Portulaca and Tropiolum or Nasturtium. And then in dried and cooler parts of India, Colensia bicolor, Fia, Dimorphotheca, Echinum, Gilia, Godetia, Limonium sinuatum, Linum, Nemesia, Ursina, Ursinia, Venedium, Saponaria, Scabiosa, Chrysanthus are the example of dried and cooler parts of plants. And then fragrant annuals, Alyssum, Giranthus, Kiri, Centaurea moschata, Dianthus caryophyllus, Carnation, Dianthus caryophyllus, Carnation, and Heliotropium, Lathyrus odoratus, Matthiola or Stox, Phlox and Reseda odorata are the fragrant annuals. And then annuals suitable for shade. So there is no annual which can survive in full shade. However, there are annuals which thrive well in depleted light or partial shade, but the quality and the quantity of the flowers get a setback. So these are Azereatum, Alyssum, Calceolaria, Calendula, Clarkia, Delphiniums including Larkspur. Godetia, Iberis, Impatience, Lobelia, Lupin, Myosotis, Nemophila, Nicotiana, Phlox, Verbena, Sinicio cruentus, Viola tricolor hortensis, Salvia are the example of annual suitable for shade. And some annuals and their culture. One is Azereatum conigioides. Another is Azereatum houstonianum or Azereatum mexicanum. The common name of Azereatum conigioides is Floss Flower. Family Composite, origin Central America. So these species are garden forms ranging nearly 15 to 45 centimeters height. 15 to 45 centimeters seed height have been bred. The dwarf types are especially suitable for beds, borders or rockeries. And the branches are covered with fluffy heads of flowers with color ranging from pale lavender to deep manure. Here you have to observe here. So Azereatum conigioides composite or also called as Asteraceae. So Azereatum are as good as potted plants when grown in pots. They should be syringed occasionally with clean water to keep down red spiders. The important cultivars are Blue Ball, Blue Ball or Dark Blue or Blue Miniature and Fairy Pink, Light Pink or Salmon Pink are there. So and then Althea rosea, the common name of Althea rosea are hollyhock, family Malvaceae, origin Orient and China. So in temperate countries and in our hill stations, this is treated as a perennial, where in the plains it behaves like an annual. It is a majestic plant. And more under favorable conditions and with rot, large, round and kidney-shaped leaves. The large single, semi-double or double flowers are borne in the axils of the leaves all along the length of the stem. So these are cultivars having fringed, petaled and carnation-like flowers. The shade of the flower varies from white to cream, yellow, scarlet, rose, lilac, mauve, deep violet, near black, etc. And cultural process is a deep, fairly rich but well-drained soil with a little of lime rubbish is ideal for its cultivation. There are many cultivars, some of them are suitable for the plains. While others are good for hills. In this type, the flowers look more showy as the leaves are small compared to leaves in the older types. Hollyhocks rust is a serious disease which is checked by dusting sulfur at 40-90 intervals. And next plant is Amaranthus. The common names of Amaranthus are Amaranth, Lovelace Bleeding, Joseph's Coat or Princess Feather. Feather. The family is Amaranthaceae. Origin means tropics. So this group comprises some useful garden annuals with bright foliage or blooms or the Lovelace Bleeding or Amaranthus caducus grows. It bears tail-like. So here this picture is enlarged by me. So you only download these pictures for understanding of the images of the plant for easy understanding and share into groups. So it bears tail like, often with knots at short intervals. So drooping flower spikes, white, pale green or crimson in color. It is useful for cutting, especially its leaves are striped. So cultivation process means here, all the above species are annuals and very easy to grow. They do well in sunny sanitation and deeply worked out soil. In shady or semi-shaded places, the color of the foliage does not develop properly. In a very rich soil also, the color tends to become dull. And then campanula medium. I hope, did you understand this one? I hope this is very useful to you. And then well understand. Campanula medium, common name Canterbury bells, family Campanulaceae, origin South Europe. It is a biennial bearing bell shaped flowers of white, blue, pink. Okay, so blue, pink. So here not only one single color of these all type of annuals. Each annual plant where several colors are there. So just some of only I kept to you. So here wearing well shaped flowers of white, blue, pink, mauve, violet colors. The flowers are single or double, and the variety Calycanthema has cup and saucer shaped flowers. The Canterbury bell is a useful plant for annual and mixed borders and also for pots. The flowers are good for cutting. Hence, they are suitable for the hill stations. But the biennials and the annual species do well in many parts of northern India. But it widely spread in South Europe. In the hills, sowing is done in autumn or spring. Partial shades is ideal for its proper growth. And then Cheiranthus cheiri, the common name of Cheiranthus cheiri is wallflower. So they are Cheiranthus cheiri flowers. The family is Cruciferae, also called as Brassicaceae. Brassicaceae. Its origin from Europe, but naturalized in Britain. So wallflower is a medium tall shrubby biennial or perennial, and they are some early flowering annuals also. Most of the grain stains are biennials. Flowering stems. Among the Giant's Flame red stains, Giant Fire Fig King is outstanding. In the early flowering annual sections, Persian wallflowers. Persian wallflowers so early wonders are important. So they flower several weeks earlier than the biennial. So wallflowers are popular for spring bedding and cutting because of their wide color range and sweet scent. So culture means here the biennial varieties can be cultivated with success only in the hills or hilly places such as Delhi, having a long cool winter. In other places, annuals will do better. The biennials will take 6 to 8 months to flower, whereas the annuals flower within 3 to 3.5 months. And then Cosmas bipinnatus, the common names of Cosmas bipinnatus are Cosmea, Losmos, Mexican aster. Family is Compositae, और ऑस्टरेसी। ऑरिजिन मेक्सिको। ए डिलाइटफुल एनिमल मेनली ग्रोन इन द रेनी सीजन। इट बेयर्स रोज, पिंक, क्रिम्सन, पर्पल, लैवेंडर एंड व्हाइट फ्लावर्स विथ येलो सेंटर ऑन लॉन्ग स्टॉक्स। And may be single or double, including some tetraploids, a yellow or orange flowering species with a protruding yellow and black center is also grown in the garden. And cultural seeds are sown during January, February, or May, June, and September, October in the hills. Same. Sowing is done during spring or autumn, and seedlings are transplanted or seeds are sown in permanent beds. It thrives in sunny or semi-shaded situations and takes about nearly 2.5 to 3 months to flowering. So ikkada complete annual plants, ఫ్లవరింగ్ యాన్యువల్ ప్లాంట్స్ అనేటివి ఎలా కల్టివేట్ చేస్తాం అనేది ఇక్కడ ఇంపార్టెంట్. సో ఇక్కడ కల్టివేట్ చేసే ప్రాసెస్లో సో మనము ఎన్ని కైండ్స్ ఆఫ్ ప్లాంట్స్ చెప్పుకున్నామంటే ఇక్కడ అర్లీ బ్లూమింగ్, ముందుగా పుష్పించే ఏకవార్షికాలు, లేట్గా పుష్పించే ఏకవార్షికాలు లేదా లేట్ బ్లూమింగ్ యానివల్స్, తెలుపు పుష్పకాలు ఉండేటివి, బ్లూ పర్పుల్ లావెండర్ కలర్ ఉండేటివి, ఎల్లో ఆరెంజ్ ఉండేటివి, అవి హ్యాంగింగ్ బాస్కెట్స్గా ఉండేటివి, కొన్ని రాకరీలో గ్రో అయ్యేటివి, కొన్ని ఫ్రాగ్రెంట్ ఇచ్చేటివి, ఇంకొన్ని షేడ్ సర్ఫేసెస్లో గ్రో అయ్యేటి అనమాట. అంటే ఫుల్లీ షేడ్ కాదు, పార్షియల్ షేడ్లో గ్రో అయ్యేటివి. సో దాంట్లో సెవరల్ స్పీసెస్ చెప్పాను ఇక్కడ, అర్లీ బ్లూమింగ్ యానివల్స్, లేట్ బ్లూమింగ్ యానివల్స్, వైట్ ఫ్లవర్డ్ యానివల్స్, నెక్స్ట్ బ్లూ పర్పుల్ అండ్ లావెండర్ ఫ్లవర్డ్ యానివల్స్, ఎల్లో ఆరెంజ్ ఫ్లవర్డ్ యానివల్స్, యానివల్స్ ఫర్ హ్యాంగింగ్ బాస్కెట్, యానివల్స్ ఫర్ రాకరీ, హ్యూమిడ్ రీజియన్స్, డ్రైడ్ అండ్ కూలర్ పార్ట్స్ ఆఫ్ ఇండియా, అండ్ ఫ్రాగ్రెంట్ యానివల్స్, యానివల్స్ సూటబుల్ ఫర్ షేడ్. సో ఇలా కంపేర్ చేసుకున్నప్పుడు కొన్ని యానివల్స్ గురించి మనం అవి ఎలా కల్టివేట్ చేస్తారు అనే దాంట్లో మనం ఇక్కడ అజరేటం, కొనిజాయిడిస్, ఆల్తియా రోజియా వీటి యొక్క లోకల్గా ఏమని పిలుస్తాము, ఏ ఫ్యామిలీ చెందినటువంటివి, ఇవి అన్నీ మన ఏరియాలో పెరిగేటటువంటి మొక్కలు కాదన్నమాట, ఇతర దేశాల్లో ఫారిన్ కంట్రీస్లో ఎక్కువగా గ్రో అయ్యేటివి. అన్నీ అవే కాదు, కొన్ని అక్కడే ఉత్పత్తి అయినటువంటివి అన్నమాట. సో అలాంటి వాటిల్లో కొన్ని మనం చెప్పుకుంటున్నాము, అజరేటము, ఆల్తియా రోజియా, నెక్స్ట్ అమరాంతస్, ఆ తర్వాత కంపానులా మీడియం, కీరాంతస్ కీరి, కాస్మాస్ బైపిన్నేటస్. సో ఇవి ఏ ఏ ఏరియాలో పెరగడానికి సూటబుల్గా ఉంటాయి, వాటికి ఎలా కేర్ తీసుకోవాలి, డయాంతస్ బార్బేటస్. సో ఇవి అన్నమాట ఇంతవరకు నేర్చుకున్నాము, కాస్మాస్ బైపిన్నేటస్ వరకు నేర్చుకున్నాము. సో ఫర్దర్ క్లాసెస్లో తర్వాత